The stochastic oscillator is one of the most useful indicators when trading. The stochastic allows you to evaluate price fluctuations and provides indications on the strength of the trend, as well as the momentum of the price, indicating entry and exit signals. The momentum is the rate of acceleration of an asset's price. The stochastic is called oscillator because it oscillates between the levels of 0 and 100. No matter how much the price on the chart moves up or down, it will always fluctuate between the levels of 0 and 100. This indicator examines how close the candle closures are to the resistance or support recorded over a specific period of time. The fundamental use of the stochastic is to identify areas of excess and to understand when the price is oversold or overbought. The overbought zone is identified when the stochastic fluctuates above the 80 level. Overbought zones give us signals to sell. The oversold zone is identified when the stochastic fluctuates below the 20 level. Oversold zones give us signals to buy. When the oscillator indicates oversold and overbought areas, you shouldn't buy or sell immediately. You always need confirmation from price action. The stochastic, when indicating the level 80 or level 20, is telling us that the trend right now is strong, and we need to be patient and have a slowdown of momentum before price can reverse. If you see a rocket going up into the sky, it will have to slow down before it starts its downside momentum, and the same applies for the price. Momentum always changes direction before price. The default stochastic period is 14 periods. This means that using the one-day time frame, 14 periods are equivalent to 14 candles of a day, therefore 14 days. On the other hand, using the one-hour time frame, 14 periods are equivalent to 14 candles of 1 hour, therefore 14 hours. The stochastic oscillator is formed by two lines. The red line is called the percentage K, also known as the fast line, and is more sensitive to price changes. The blue line is called percentage D, also known as the slow line, and is the one that allows you to generate buy or sell signals. Once the indicator arrives in the overbought or oversold area, you have to wait for the red line to cross the blue line in the direction of the new trend, giving us further confirmation. This intersection must be combined with price action analysis, having candlestick closures that confirm the new direction. Another very effective method to use the stochastic is by analyzing the divergence between the price and the oscillator. A divergence is simply a price movement that is not confirmed by the stochastic, indicating a potential reversal. A bullish divergence occurs when the price shows a lower low, but the stochastic showing a higher low. A bearish divergence occurs when the price shows a higher high, but the stochastic shows a lower high. These divergence signals indicate the end of a trend and a potential trend reversal. Divergence analysis helps to avoid liquidity traps, and above all helps to understand the best time to enter the market.